Wickham Lake subdivision where folks are mainly staying indoors.
It's a stinky situation in parts of Brevard County.
You know, if you pass through a fish market, how strong, but I mean, that's fresh fish, and it still smells. This one was stinky type of smell.
Midweek, you couldn't catch Hector Collazo walking his little chihuahua around his neighborhood. The smell of dead fish kept him locked up inside.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Never.
Thousands of dead fish surfaced in this lake.
This is where all the fish were. Approximately maybe 6 foot.
The smell lingered all over.
On the lake's edge here in the Wickham Lake subdivision, you can still get some pretty good whiffs of the dead fish coming on in. But residents here say midweek the smell was much worse.
Saw their bodies washed up yesterday afternoon with the breeze pushing them into the corner over here.
Finally getting back to the morning stroll with his dog Max, Mark Groover and his neighbors had no clue what was causing the sea of fish to surface.
Called the Florida Fish and Wildlife group yesterday just to report it.
Turns out the early arrival last week of chilly winds to Florida might have turned over ponds and lakes in Brevard County. That means low oxygen water from the bottom churned up, suffocating fish, big and small. It's a smorgasbord for birds, turtles, and gators. Some of the dead fish were eaten up. Others are sinking to the bottom, taking the bad smell along the way.
Definitely so. Glad to see the stink has gone away.
In Vieira, Jeff Lennox, West 2 News.
Florida Fish and Wildlife says dead fish have been surfacing all across the state. Coco and Suntree also reporting fish kills this week.